Dingo. Oops, not muted. Thinking about it, that song is also probably copyright. Hi. It is a remix of three copyrighted songs, so I really just wanted to test how it would get detected. That's okay. Hi, how are you doing today, Dingo? I don't know. Like, you gotta tell me so that I can answer your question. Hey, cutie. Congratulations on affiliate, by the way. Use some of your emotes in my chat. I got Reese's Puffs in the bowl. No, you are cutie. Big cutie. No, I'm not. I'm 30 inches. Not 30 inches. 30 centimeters tall. I'm actually using a magnifying glass to appear this large on your screen. I'm actually like... real size. Look, I'm not even as tall as chat. I can still lick you, though. Hey, go over here. Yeah. Licked. Oh, I'm fucking with my camera now. Hang on. Smooth that over a little bit. There we go. Now I can sway again. Oh no, it's lagging. So small, can barely like. It's okay. Hi, Shar. Love. Come here. Got your colon. Just like real life. Now that's a pun. Your punctuation colon, clearly. Clearly. Twice. Pick your lumps. Oh god, you can see the back of my you can see the back of my pupil because I turned up the detection here. Oh, that's totally fucking with my sense of reality. I really need to get that fixed. Char, please. Well, it's my fault for turning the setting all the way up, but I really like being expressive by being able to do this, you know? A lot of my expression is my eye movement, after all. And then it's like leaking through my face. Maybe I have to do. Maybe I do have it too high. That's not on Char. Pippinmint, hey. I'm just fucking around with my eye settings. Look, it's okay. It'll all be magically fixed on the outfit update model, because that's how programming works. Oh, it's gay strength. To a boring level. There we go. You normally don't even get that close anyway, but, like, it starts to ruin the illusion, you know? That I'm cute. Got Reese's Puffs and Bowl. Espa. Hi, love. Sorry, I was looking at my own eyes, and then I went off-road like I was Peter Griffin staring at my own pretty face. Programming is four people sitting in a group call troubleshooting something optional for a total of 10 hours? No. Programming is four people sitting in a group call troubleshooting something optional for a total of 10 hours while wearing stripy leg socks. Get it right. All programmers are trans. It's okay. I hit the dot. You couldn't see it on screen. Sorry.
Hi. Hi, chat. Hi, chat.
Who's this? Is that an E? Hang on, let me click this. I don't want to call you Darthicus by accident. Yeah, Darthicus Dubious. Hi, welcome. Sorry, the color of the red got me against the OBS background. You did not own any? Lob, are you sure you're trans? I mean, even I own some. Come on. Not that I wear in public. I did say that. It's okay. You can be honorary trans. Listen, let nobody tell you what you are, okay? Self-identity is called self-identity for a reason, after all. What is that level of gatekeeping? Oh, you don't have strippy socks? sorry. Welcome to the stream, Darthicus. I'm usually a little less energetic these days, but I found some energy today. You own fake Booba, and I don't. You're more trans than I am. What is this gatekeeping now? Still, I'm very happy for you about that. That's good. You got another 30 months to think about it. Yeah. Yeah. Just move to Finland, Fivehead. Finland passed a law. Sweden, where Finland goes, Sweden follows. I'm surprised that it didn't automatically take effect in Sweden as soon as Finland passed it, I'll be honest. Like, that's not even new news, that's just how they've always been. They're closer friends than the United States and Canada. We were just about to go do Beat Saber, so even though it pains you to leave my favorite stream, I must go. That's okay, Char. I know that you don't like me as much as your audience. That's okay. Rory is also live, and so is Gertie. So I'm streaming on top of everybody else's feet right now. So don't take any offense to it. Just go have your fun stream and come back all sweaty and keep your pants on this time, okay? If you can. What are we working on? A 50-year-old law. Glad to be here. You love your look. Reminds me of Kid Icarus. Oh. Well, I guess, yeah, the holly leaves. That's like a European holly because Vespa is a poison fairy. Vespa's my TRPG character that I happen to have a model of that my friend and now girlfriend, Char, rigged up for me for free as a favor. I had to do a little bit of YouTubing, and now it's 5 months later, and I'm still doing it, and I have more followers than she does. Ah! It's okay. We'll get you there, Char. We'll get you there. We'll get you there. We'll get you there. You two love. Slower, though, because Char is more important.
Ah!
I'm joking, of course. I don't rate people like that. Anyway, how is everybody else doing tonight? I have a bit too much energy, but that's because I'm not feeling well. I have a bit of a nose thing. Oh yeah, you guys were like the first who allowed it, and then your laws are the most restrictive. It's sort of like our constitution, how it was the first modern democracy and the last to adhere to modern democracy stuff, by which I mean there's no chance we'll ever be able to update it until well, if we ever held a constitutional convention, all the red states would immediately try and trash everything to do with the constitution, because all of their politics are, well, it doesn't actually mean that. Meanwhile, it was supposed to be a living document updated every 20 years by the majority of people, but They didn't foresee political parties. Of all things, they didn't foresee political parties. You don't need a nose, just sell it to somebody. I have a nose. Right there. Why am I so shaky today? Is that just my energy? My latent energy? Or is it just because the tracking is garbage today? Maybe the camera's dirty? Let me check. I'm about to fucking destroy this camera. Hang on. There's no way it kept tracking me through a literal flashlight on it, but whatever. I am very big today. Fix that. Nose boops redeem when? I use VC Face. See? I don't actually know how to set up boop. There was like tits, but I don't think that's a plugin for this one. And since my computer is already running pretty rough, it's probably not a good idea. I'm going to have a new outfit soon, by the way. Char is working on it. It's great. I'm so excited. I'm not going to show anything on stream until it's done, but I'm happy. I've been showing everybody the updates that she makes because she's so great, and I love her. And you'll see that in like a week. Like a week. Also, I ordered the capture card, and they still haven't shipped it. That'll probably arrive at the same time. So now it's just a contest of which one of those happens first. And I suppose I'll use my leap motion while I got my new outfit on. Do, like, a just chatting stream. Boop. Hey, Sarah Lee. Patty at Pat. Hong Kong. I'm not going to show anybody. Shows everybody. Well, yeah, I'm showing them in private. That's different. I mean, if they really wanted to see it, they could just go to Char's stream. Watch her VODs. Go follow Char. Go follow Char. Dingo, shout out Char. Dingo, you're not a mod. I can shout out Char. Everybody go follow my best girl, virtually Char, please. Are you a mod? No, you're a VIP. It's whatever. I can mod my own shit. Reese's Puffs in the bowl. That is now stuck in my head. What if you don't follow? I don't know. You're not showing up in the viewer list either, so you must be watching more than 3 streams right now. Which means you're not even counting as a viewer right now, Sarah Lee. Why are you even here? I'm joking. It's good to see you. Okay. What if you don't follow Char? Your eyes. I will eat them. But you don't have to worry about that, because you already follow her, don't you? Anyway. Let's play video games. I wanted to go over the updates to... That's not Vore. It's just that you're not using them because you don't see how cute Char is. Hitting the buttons. Wait, which buttons do I actually have to hit in order to get the game to launch? This might not be a good day for concentrating on a video game. Just saying, folks. I have Pathfinder 2E later. But that's like later. Still, it'll be good. We're gonna have fun. That'll be on Midnight Queen Lillian's stream, and I will be sending people there from the Discord. Oh, you can see my knees bend. Later in 12 hours? Later in like 6 hours. I wasn't sure if it was 6 or 7, but I'm just scratching the back of my neck. But we'll see. That button and that button. Now, there is a lot to read. Okay, so that update came out that I was excited about, the Rainpunk 2 update. I played one as doing that. Yeah. I gotta say, it was fun. It was very nice, and I wasn't missing Sparkdew like I thought I would be. However, there's something over here we gotta take a look at. Check this out. A vote for a fifth race. We got Toad People. Hang on, let me hide chat for just a moment. I can still see you guys, don't worry. A resilient and strong species that seems to really enjoy the rain. They specialize in the use of hydraulics and dealing with toxic substances. Then we have the Bat People, which have like some kind of cool snout thing made of metal. A fierce and aggressive species, augmented by Rainpunk technology. They specialize in dealing with infused rainwater and have a love for brawling and luxury. So they're sort of, oh look, like they have natural wings and then they have mechanical arms. That's kind of awesome. I like this, I mean, frogs, yeah, the frogs are cool. But let's not forget that my vote is only one vote and it's not going to swing the thing. But I am rooting for the frogs. Look how they have, like, a mustache that's not really a mustache. However, I do have a natural distaste for frogs because they want to eat me whole. But we don't talk about that on this stream. The bats are cute, though, look. I know a lot of YouTubers that'd be happy about that. And I know a lot of dingoes that would be happy about the furry race. A majestic species living in a symbiotic relationship with a blight rot. They possess a strong affinity to the forest and feel at home in the wilderness. Yeah, no. Not them. You also can't see my cursor because I'm not clicked in, but yeah, no, not them. Affinity with blight rot and the trees is very, like, remarkable, but also... we like dwarves in this house and beavers and not elves, okay? Elves are fine, I guess, but not when we're being dwarves, like in this game with the beavers. So I'm feeling like voting bats. What did you say before? If you don't follow, just follow her. It's not like it costs you anything. What do you guys think? Which one should I vote for? It's your Pathfinder character. Which one? The Bat Girl? That's Lillian right there. Oh, sit up, stretch, and sippy. And I didn't hear the alert. That's annoying. Why did the alert not come through? Let me see here. Have a good nap. No, I should be able to hear it. That's weird. Do you mean the fox girl? Okay, but are you also, like, symbiotically parasited by death blight rot? I'm voting bats. If you guys own the game, you can vote for who you want, but I'm voting bats because they seem coolest. And, I mean, the other two races are designed anyway, so I'm sure that they'll get put in eventually, you know? It's good. Now, there are a lot of changes to read. That opened on its own page, and now I'm lagging. Alright, they revamped the Rain Collector. I also saw when I was in there, this new building, the Advanced Rain Collector. I didn't use either of them yet. I only played one upgrade.
Watch out! But I was...
Oh, it's playing through that. Turn that up over there. I got Reese's Puffs in the bowl. I'm sorry. That's the only reason I added it to Pixie Mix to begin with. Thank you for the lurk, Dingo. There's the fifth species vote. There's new cornerstones, forest mysteries, glade events.
Hey! Listen!
Hi, what's up, Lob? I'm a cutie? Thank you. Are you sure you don't want to vote for the word? Say the word challenge? New cornerstones, forest mysteries, glade events. Oh yeah, upgradable geyser pumps. You can now put a little robot fella in the geyser pump if it's too far away, which is awesome. It keeps you from having to send somebody over there to work. I played a little bit with the water update, and it is kind of cool. I was not playing on Prestige 10. So I was playing Prestige 3 like a chump, like I normally do. Right, the community vote, developer notes. And then there's a whole bunch of little changes here, such as the removal of Sparkdew, which is not a little change at all. Rainwater is collected based on the season you're in. It can collect infused with rainwater and has an internal tank, doesn't require a geyser. So you can start collecting all three types of rainwater right off the gate by, right off the gate? Right out of the gate by getting those set up. And they still don't cost anything, if I recall, so that's good. You just have to, like, use pipes to build them now, I think. Some new glade events that are tied to Blight Rot, which I won't be reading. I don't want to spoil myself on those. 6 new forest mysteries. 4 new cornerstones. The Advanced Rain Collector works the same way as a regular rain collector, but it has a larger rainwater tank, higher production speed, and collects more water. It is unlocked as a normal blueprint upon reaching level 15, so we already have it. Added upgrades to geyser pumps, tank capacity increase, and 2 automatons. And that requires hearth cores that I usually sell off, so I'll probably be selling those a bit less, hopefully. And the new prestige modifier for Prestige 2 is the Blight Swarm. I played around with it. In my game, it hit me for like 50% blight each 3 years, so that was fun. Blight Rot cysts are now generated every X water used in rain engines. The previous system was too convoluted. The greenhouse and clay pit no longer allow you to install rain engines, instead they use rainwater directly to produce goods. I played around with this, it is actually just part of the crafting recipe that you could choose. Your hair is currently drying? Nice, nice. Well, don't play this game, because it's raining constantly. You'll never get dry. Rebalanced all pipe recipes and changed the trading value for pipes. It's now a lot cheaper to make them and buy them. Something, something, something. I didn't really play that much of the last update alone. I was waiting for this. Let's see here. Added more resource options to the Scarlet Orchards, archaeological discoveries, Archie, what? The cost of building small hearths has been increased from 1 to 2 wildfire essences. I didn't see that before. At the same time, the trade value of this resource was lowered by almost half, and the number of wildfire essences given to the player at the start of the game is doubled. Interesting. So you don't get as much for selling them off, and you need more of them. I suppose that's because I was playing Monohearth, and other people were also. There are delivery orders involving the new rainwater, which is awesome. Increase the chance for copper ore from clay deposits. We're starting to hit the stuff that doesn't even fucking matter. Hang on, let me mute this. Just had to do a gross snort. UI improvements and bug fixes. There's some other stuff here. Tweaked the volume levels of glade effect. Event sound effects. I see. 3 new music tracks. Nice. Improve the game's overall performance in settlement mode, especially in towns with a lot of farms and crops. Interesting. Okay, so the game should be performing a bit better too. But that's enough of that. They've also released some hotfixes to fix bugs that came out with the update. But I'm not going to go over every single one of those. I put Time of Temple down here because it was next to that one that did timed orders. And I wanted to reveal some of this chunky, good, whole bunch of like real packed together question marks. That said, I only really have time for one more settlement on this timeline, unless I play one quick and then have another chance. I played this one pretty quick, but that was because I was on Prestige 3. Now, what are these? A lot of ruined buildings can be found, and you'll gain 2 more hostility points per villager. Hostility doesn't grow with each passing year. I want to kind of settle right between these two, because we need these gears. This is a new one, so I'm not certain. No, haven't I done this before? Now my brain's lying to me, too. These come with extra planks. This one comes with a bit of wood and some bit of oil. And this one comes with a bit of cooked foods. Gotta be said, Oh, and a little bit of wood. I think I like starting with the cooked foods, but that'll be gone fast, you know? I wonder, though, if we can get early prestige points off that. Or early victory points. I'm not certain that I want to play on Prestige 11 until I've played around with the new system a bit more. If I play on Prestige 11, this is going to take all day. Which, I mean, some people like, but let's just take a look at what we can do here first. I like the one where we have harpies and start with cloth. I like that a lot, actually. Especially since we start with extra, oil? Oh, this one also has wood, so I was just looking at the wrong thing completely. It starts with extra fiber. Okay. Looks like they adjusted the value of some of these. Not that I'm complaining. Harpies liked... not ale. They liked education, brawling, and cleanliness, right? So let's go with the scroll delivery line, I think, this time. Could be nice, and it's a bit cheaper than the gear delivery. What else? Might be cool to start with extra packs. Packs out of the gate would be really good. A little bit of extra food to cover for the jerky when that runs out. Or I could just start with extra cloth. I mean, we got 21 already, and that would really let us make sure that we had enough harpy housing. Or, You know what? I'm gonna go with the coal. I don't know if I have beavers, lizards, or humans. I don't know which one I'm missing. So, I want to have that coal, just in case, because I might not be able to put a beaver in there to speed up. So, we're going to call this one... what do we call this one? I'm going to call it Glizzy Shire, after the hot dog. And we will leave it on Prestige 3, just so we can get used to the, light... hot. Now, we don't get year-over-year pain, but we will get pain added per villager. We'll have to be careful. This is the new one there, Blight Swarm. 5 Light Rot Cysts appear in the settlement. Ruined buildings, a ton of them can be found nearby. Okay, it looks like we have 5 and 6 here, so what's this? Living matter will spawn on one farm field every 70 seconds. Cloudburst. Every villager in your settlement will take one coat. If you cannot provide the goods, global resolve will be lowered by -6. Eerie Song. Villagers have a 5% chance of perishing every 15 seconds. That's amazing. We'll try and stay under that. And villagers take 200% longer breaks. Yikes. So they take breaks 3 times as long, basically. Triple the length.
Triple.
Looks like we got an X here for the pave, for the roads. Gotta go this way. Boop. Do one that way, a little bit this way, get rid of those. Looks like we started out with some fertile soil, which is really, really cool. I'm gonna make sure that we gain our access to that. Looks like just one of these is not good. Speaking of which, what do we got? Clay pit off the bat. Alternatively, we could get smelter for a good source of pipes. Skewers for a good source of food. But I think having a supply of clay and reed early might be really, really good. This does use, I think, clearance water. I don't know. I think you could choose. What do you guys think? Everybody's lurking. Very sad. I don't think we have copper on the map, really. So these three buildings aren't necessarily like what we have to focus on. Let's focus on the clay pit. Now this is interesting because I just took a different thing for the fertile soil. Let me check something. We can use reeds here, here, and here. So I'm gonna take the ranch, so we have access to the meat, leather, and eggs. As for this, supplier could be cool. I've really been undervaluing water skins and flour. Not water skins, but like container stuff. Flour, barrels, and pack of provisions on this one. Meanwhile, this one has scrolls, ammo, and simple tools. We are getting scrolls every minute, so I think I'm going to go with provisioner. The only difference is they both have flour, but this one has a different type of storage item. Yo, wait a minute. I think I should go with the supplier. I have a source of leather, after all, from the ranch I took. Yeah. And we can get planks production, and that's important. This thing is huge! A 3x3? Holy crap. Okay, okay. What does that take? Flour, planks, water skins. Okay, Jesus. I guess we'll put it over in the corner here. Although it's not a priority. We are gonna need the crude workstation, of course. Not there. Makeshift post would only be for making the provisions early. That's okay for now. Let us get... Oh, right, we are right up against this. Fuck, okay. Forgot to do the entire path. Move this over a little bit. Fire. And rain collector fits right in there. That one I sort of want early. We're also gonna need our trading post, of course. Doesn't fit in there, so we'll just stick it over here. Of course, that's not nearly as important as our clay pit and our ranch, which I believe we will try and fit in over here. I actually want to do something here. I'm going to put a warehouse in down here. It's a bit early for this, but sort of want to try just speeding things up by doing that. Oh, sorry. What's the clay pit taking? Ah, right. We can fit two clay pits here. One there and one here. Or like that. Oh, that's dumb. It's really dumb. What we should do. No, okay. No, hang on. I'm doing maths in my head that don't even matter. Harpy houses. As we have only harpies and we have all this cloth, I want to get these out. There we go. More road this way. I'll go in like this, and I sort of need to move the warehouse already. Okay, okay. Warehouse here? Not the best idea. We'll save the stuff for a warehouse, but we don't really need it right now. I do want that ranch, though, if possible. Put in maybe over here. I'll have, like, this food corner going on. Let's just focus on the cutting for now. Oh, my harpies. Let's see what we get out of that first little thing. Okay. Looks like they're building a ring collector first for some reason. That's okay. They have plenty of parts. Not plenty of wood though. Okay, I want to start collecting. Just a little bit. Let's pull two harpies. Okay, wait a minute. We'll get four harpies in. We don't have to worry about the speed of the game. We have to worry about, not you, the amount of villagers. Eight villagers is 96. Holy shit. So, wow, okay. Those harpies will build, these guys will collect their rainwater. Actually, I want one more harpy in there collecting rainwater. Oh. I don't really like this one, because by the time you can make cosmetics, you don't really need it. Cannibalism, though. Additional villagers would be interesting if I could also take cannibalism. Or walker training. These guys are cutting when I need them to. Oh, right. Wait, but before we do anything, I just want to make sure. Yeah, no hearth. Good. Or rather, no oil in the hearth. We do need this, everyone. Although we do also need clay pit, I can set that up later. I just need to be collecting this rainwater early. We can't really boost this, but whatever. Orders. I'm gonna leave that alone for now. There's no penalty for taking them later. Good, good, cannibalism, bad. Cannibalism's a very powerful trait, I'll have you know. Alright, let's also shop over here. Eat the insects for now. We'll empty this out for just a moment. Tried to hit many buttons there, that none of them were the right ones. Alright, there's the crew workstation. I don't have that many harpies, actually. I'll need to be careful. Also, a bit slower, but I don't need fabric or bricks right now, I just need planks. Just to get up everything I need to. Okay, I guess I do need bricks, but whatever. We have a little bit. Huh. Move them back down here. That'll be good to collect eventually. Once it starts being in the way. I do want to open that lid. But maybe clearing out this one would be good too. Don't know why I paused. Looks like we managed to get 52 barrels of water during that, which is absolutely great. We do have the space for the clay pits. Let's make sure that they get put in. Also the ranch. One over here. The clay pit. No, I want the ranch over here. What am I talking about? Alright. Runch. Plus this one. Clay pit. And then one more clay pit there. Then we will focus on. And this takes planks. Okay, warehouse can go in right away. We aren't gonna need both clay pits right away, so just that one and this one. Move that out of the way. I did take off one of the harpies just to get an extra builder going. I think it's going okay. Quick save. Who's the trader that's coming? Her. Okay, just making sure. I'm gonna try this order. Not a bad order, but I actually want this. That tanning rack is going to be good. Yeah, we'll do that. I like this one better, currently. As for this one, I don't have enough information yet. I think I'm going to take this. I don't know if I'll even have a source of copper, but let's just make sure. Plus ones are good, and we can actually get this done. We do need more planks, so I will actually move one in there. And, home button. That'll help a lot, actually. They don't have to trek all the way over here in order to dump stuff. Hopefully they actually put this together at some point. Unfortunately, this is blue water, so I can't even have any yet. We do not have that much clearance water. Uh-oh. Let's pull one woodcutter for over there. I can afford the other woodcutter as well. There we go. We need that production first. And we get to save up on this clearance water. Nice. Ooh, 2-2. Okay. Ooh. Worth taking. Let's see. First is leather. We need 15 meat, 15 leather. Of course, we prioritize the one thing we're gonna have a shitload of. There we go. And we'll need that and that up first. Hopefully we have some lizards to run that. Play pit, I don't think gets any bonus. Let's turn off clay. This is clearance water here. 1000% clearance water, okay. We'll need to get a piss geyser eventually, but here's something funny. They actually carry a barrel of water into their little domain. Going to take a peek. Alright. We already have zero hostility, so we're not going to have any sort of effect go on this season. I'm gonna pull the other woodcutter though, just because I want extra building. We have enough wood right now. We can speed that up. We could literally take as many years as we want on this because we don't have any hostility over time. Because of the thing, so we could literally just sit and produce if we need to. Of course, I mean, we're gonna get less points the longer we take, but whatever. They get their houses up and running, that's important. Still have two that don't have a house, that's not great, but they'll fix it. That looks, yeah. Shit. If you leave rainwater for a while, it will begin to release a pleasant and warm vapor. Food production speed is increased by 10% for every 50 units of drizzle water stored. Every 50 units. Okay, so that's not as good as it looks at first glance. Each completed dangerous or forbidden late event. Every 5 villagers with a need for education fulfilled will increase global production speed by 25%. I am getting scrolls over time, but I don't think it's that much. I wouldn't want to take that before I actually had a way of using it. Protected trade is amazing, because since I don't have that hostility over time, I can basically pay for the villagers. That's awesome. We got beavers, everybody. That's so good. Here you go. And since we just took that perk, we can get a lot more out of this. However, I don't think that we have anything that's really worth selling to her. We have a lot of gears, but it's not going to do much. Sort of need them too. I could buy one of these two perks, if I wanted to. Food production speed could be important later, because this does affect the ranch. Woodcutters move. Food production speed also affects the complex food. I actually really want that then. Biscuits can now be produced in the kiln of the rain mill. Useful, but not when I have no money. 15? We are down to one cloth already? Jesus. I could make cloth out of reeds, actually. I need a lot of reeds, then. Means I need a lot of drizzle water. How are we on planks? We have 18 planks. How are we on bricks? We have 3. Not good. I think that works. It works for me, at least. I'm gonna take that Viceroy Survival Guide. Get out of here. Hang on. I need to spend 1.1 more in order to get slightly... Here you go, lady. You can have these eggs, and I'll take, three pots.
Yes.
Thank you. Ooh, I do want more pots, actually, if possible. Like I said, I've been neglecting getting... Wait a minute. Let's think. Yeah. I have the leather into the, water skins. Although I will definitely use meat for that because I'm actually making that. Okay. We actually do have plank production here. That's good. Although we don't have anything to feed in for flour. Turn that off for now. Planks are the most important, all about water skins, but I can just leave them at the same. As for this, we only need one person in the supplier, I think. We don't need two people in the rain collector, and that is drizzle season again. Could do this. Crank out all of this stuff. Ain't really a way to boost the clay pit, sadly, so we'll leave one in there and two in the clay pit. How's that sound? It will drain all of our clearance water, but then we can just move straight to that. No wood. That's weird. I need 7 amber in order to get this trade thing. On the other hand, we will be getting the trade thing. Are you guys gonna deliver these reeds anytime? Or are you gonna just sit on them? Okay, you're gonna just sit on them. That's cool. We don't have any housing for the beaver lads, so let's make sure that we're getting that too. Need to move that. We need to get into a glade this time. Let's go for both of them. Focus that one first, though. Don't need anybody in the rain collector. Not that, not that, this. And that's why I saved the berries. We got more orders coming down. Ooh. I don't have the oil to sacrifice into this. However, it is an amazing opportunity to take that. What's this? Rain engines installed. I can't take that and that. Hang on a sec. Who we got coming? He doesn't bring fuel usually, so he won't have the oil, probably. There's still a chance, but I'm not taking it. I don't know how I would even get 6 oil at this point. I do need Need for Clothing Fulfilled happening, and that's fabric production, which is amazing, so. Alright, what's next? 5 beaver, or +2 to water skins. I want this one, obviously. That means we need to be running trade routes, but that's okay, we will be soon. For now, let's just make sure there's a path, that's all. We can get a resolve point now that we have another race. That's good, that came up. Bro, can we cut, like, a single bit of this, please? What do we got? Ooh, Forgotten Temple of the Sun. That's not good. That's not good. That's not good at all. Oh, shit. I don't think he'll bring any of that. That's not good. Huh. Well, that sucks. Hey, buddy. I would want this. It's not good. That's not good at all. Plantation. Whoa. Look at this. Range on a plantation might actually cover all of that, but it's not going to have enough people in it. Let's rebuild it. I can't do shit here. We're gonna have to wait that 30 seconds. Push anything out over here, please. Ooh, wait, drizzle season. Pop back out. You pop out. I'm sure that I've already got a couple of trade route packs. Three is fine. Don't wanna sell the oil yet. Two harpies in there. Please hurry. What do you mean, no planks? God damn it. Get out of there then. Any beavers here? Little resolve.
Hello.
Worst trader visit. They're yelling at me, but I needed it. Ingo, welcome back. It had an update. Did they apply to the new reworked systems? Yes. Wait, where are all the lizards? I don't... What do you mean they... No! Dingo, you know that there are 4 races and 3 race slots, right? I don't always have lizards, and I only have 2 races right now. I don't know what the 3rd one is yet. Chill out. They wouldn't remove lizards. Go to details real quick on this. Change that. I am running my computer a little hard, but that's okay. He knows how to prioritize. Yeah. Alright. Harvesting crops is faster, building capacity. Greenhouse, I would really, really like. Wait. However, before anything, I need to fix this. 10 tools. That's gonna hurt.
Papa.
Don't call me Papa. Or whatever the fuck you just said. Do I even have the stuff for this? That's all of my food. Wait a minute. I can take the meat back. That hurts. I need to sell all of my gears? Are you kidding me? Hang on. Maybe not all of them? Yes, all of them. Well, maybe not all of them. Let's save two gears somehow. Ugh, that hurts, but I'll take it. Low on food. I know. What difficulty are you trying the new update in? This is difficulty 3. Oh. Well, I guess we are low on food. We need the harpies that are doing everything over here. We have to pump the ranch out, if possible. We are pulling way too much clay pit water. Yeah, let them do that. We have a bit of reeds, right? Yeah, just get that doing. And then I need one harpy. Or was it harvester camp? No, not the harvester camp. Brain, are you happening? What's the supplier even doing right now? Oh, they're making water skins. Beautiful. 2 in here. Using tools. Investigate. We will get 3 ancient tablets out of that. And more coal, which will be helpful. I don't really know what I want to do with this last RPL. I might just leave her up to build the... Oh, we do not have any planks. Planks, please. Do that. Let's take some food back. Oh, there's all the planks. Why were they there? Oh my god, I put somebody in here before removing that. Here, you go build the viewers their houses. Regaining clearance water? I guess we are. Oh, we have big root. Big root. From a quick look around, did they also change the death and victory GUI? This? No. This is impatience, by the way, not death. I hope. Do I have enough resources to swing 5 of these? No, not even remotely, but I do need 5 of those. I do this. That's 3. Two bricks. Cool. That gives me 2 more people. 2 wildfire and 6 simple tools. Nice. And that's what I was looking for. Nice. Excellent. That can go in once I get the fucking gears back. Why don't you idiots focus on cutting over here? Whoever's available. Oh, human! Okay, so we don't have lizards this time. Sorry. The cute fairy is taking your attention? Who's that? Who could that be, I wonder? How are we on planks now? 12. You can go back to doing either or. And we are slowly getting reputation through this, which is nice. However, we do have hostility now that we have to trade down eventually. Is this done? Oh, it's already done. Cool. How are we doing on trades? Oh, not you. We could sell it all over oil. Is it worth doing that, maybe? I'm not really using it for anything right now. It's only 1 pack, and it gets that up so that we get better trades. I do want to clear this out. That'd be really nice. We do have space down here now for a new trade post. So that we can move the other one. How are we on this? Hub level. Encampment. Need more people housed. We're short on harpy housing. Just need this flax field Or this one specifically has to be. They're a snap. And they're human. You do not need harpy collecting rainwater. Or woodcutter. There we go. Perfect. We can repair this during this rain season. And I think, before we even chop any trees down, we can probably get at least a little bit here. Hurry up. Thank you for the lurk, Dingo. Reclaim a little bit of space. We can live out there. Now, this plantation fits well here-ish, which gives it, well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 fields it can work. Which would be perfect if I bring the human over here, actually.
Monde.
And one of the harpies. That'll work on its own. We can do... We're getting plant fiber already, so let's get berries. Grain production, leather production. Every additional leather, gain additional leather every yield. Right, I already know that. Let's take the tanning racks. We don't have enough leather right now, so less reliant on meat. Can we afford to take those? I think we can. We'll take the harpies. They come with an extra human, which is helpful. We can work two people in the clay pit right now, and the rain accelerator, collector, we don't really need to overstock. Let's get two people working in the camp. Three chopping. Once we have a source of this, I'll be able to do a lot more with the other clay pit. For now, though, it's fine. You guys just not have any? Okay, fine. I'll also use that. We got a second harpy over there. This is a weird path that has become a problem, sort of, but that's okay. The humans sort of know what they're doing over here. Amazingly enough, actually, that works if I just move this path. Think about another harpy house here. Ah, forager camp. This is gonna be human, right? Yep. We don't have the humans to run it right now, but we can get at least one person in there. How are we doing on reproduction? You're doing okay. Takes a long time, doesn't it? I guess it doesn't count as food production, so this doesn't help. This. Oh. Yes. How are we on trade routes? Forgot to that. Alright, so what we need is more makeshift posts, but I also need that built, so let's take you and we're good on green right now. Or good getting green right now, whatever. What do we even have for this? Meat? We don't actually have the food to be doing that. Focus entirely on foraging that Human house goes in. Very cool. Would be nice to house them a little bit closer to their actual place of work. We can afford to move it. Wait for that tree to go down. Yep. There we go. Put in some roads for them. Here's a problem. Wow, okay. I like this tools option. Especially because of the money that comes out of it. Yes. Definitely. I'm getting impatient quick. Look, they even managed to... That's good. Actually, we will have enough berries to start doing makeshift posts. Ah, right. I will need to put a blight post in. Soon. Oh, world. We have space for it. Ritter arrives to Hilda.
Legolas.
Legolas again? I see. Officer camp, whatever. Ale production, biscuits, mold supply. None of that's important, lady. What is important is that we have shit to trade with you. I shouldn't sell those unless I need to. Just trade offers for that later on. Wait, did they make that 25 instead of 15? Huh. Oh yeah, they definitely reduced that holy shit. These are still worth a damn fortune. There we go. Just buying the stuff we need. It works. As they say. Sort of want more pipe, if I can afford it. Could. Yeah, whatever. I never saved the tablets. My own fault, but whatever. I want that right now. Yeah, they totally did. Hey, but we still got minus 60. It's not bad. Where are you guys going? I got another warehouse in. Bit weird to put it here, but... I mean, it works. Right? Here. We can actually move this down here then. Alright. They've not had anything to cut this entire time. I'm a fool. Alright. Okay. Avoid glids. And then just, like, go. Probably end up moving that for a second ranch or something. Oh, yeah. For now, stop using the rainwater, please. We don't need another blight cyst. Not you. There. Is there even space over here to cut chopping? Yeah, there is. before anything else, let's do that. Oh, and I just gave myself two poor people right in before the storm. However, we can probably... Oh, okay, so we are on one now. That's okay. What do we have here? Luxury cleanliness or a greenhouse for the mushroom herbs. Greenhouse is so useful. We can sacrifice some of this area here and get one in here. We can also maybe move the clay pit out. There we go. I don't know. You know what? We can leave that open for now. That's fine. Greenhouse. In there. A little bit high, but that's okay. We could upgrade this. Just a little bit of gardening. There's absolutely no way through. Oh, they have too many already. There we go. You guys work, hang on, greenhouse is humans. We can get mushrooms and herbs that way. And this one actually gets that bonus as opposed to this one. Oh, we do have a human. Actually, we could probably switch out on the ancient hearth, but that's okay. Look at that cool-ass flame. Oh. There we go. Calming water. Hostility is reduced by 10 points every time you use 150 units of rain or water in engines. Jesus. Global resolve is probably better. Exploration training. Brawling fulfilled. This. That one's never made sense to me, because you need, like, early service. And we don't do that. In this house. We do have the supplier, right? Yeah, it's over there. Okay. Ooh, we do need Harpy Harpy. Human. Claro. Human, human. Harpy. No, we need this one. We're out of gears. We could also probably afford to get another harpy in here because we are not running any low on clearance water whatsoever. And that means we don't have any lizards for working this, but that's okay. We can get back to boosting. Let's need this to go up. Ooh, that's why. Okay. Oh, and we need, of course, copping happening. If you guys don't mind. I'll just work on that. Oh, that means that the harpies aren't happy enough. Happies aren't harpy enough. But we desperately need that space because we no longer have space. Oh, wow, you can move it now that it, even though it has blight rot. That's weird. Harpy territory in these parts. Be harpy, be healthy. Alright. Now we need... What else do we need? Another human house, and we need a dwarf house. That actually works just fine. We can put something nice in here once that's cleared out. It's only have one pack. What happened? Oh. Right. Makeshift toast. This doesn't use... Yeah. We want to use that stuff. And that stuff. They plant like 12, so it's fine. Oh, 4 already. Wow. Ah, eggs. Oh, we can only sell one, but that's good. Eventually, I want to put this in just to get in there. I'll probably chop out that way either way.
Okay.
Let's focus that. Good shit. Shuffle nonsense around. I like how they both get in this one tile. It's funny.
Oh.
Ritter. Caravan.
Oh. Flutra.
Flutra. Call me a slut. You heard it. Don't want people that I can't control the number of, so we'll just get money out of that. Or rather, I don't need extra people right now. How am I even getting insects? I guess the roots produce them? Works for me. We'll hang on to the money. That stuff's getting handled. New more trade routes done. But we aren't getting enough eggs. How's the runch doing? We're not getting enough reeds to produce here. I guess we can also use berries in certain spots, but like what? What are you doing? Here, do that. Oh, we're out of rainwater. We're pretty much out of clearance water. Oh, they actually were still using that. Sorry. If I wanted to fund it all without using a guy. Oh, hey, hell yes. I didn't even realize that was there. That's okay. Harpies aren't too happy with me right now. Obviously. I have somehow managed to house all of them in, like, not shack buildings. But I do need at least one big shelter for when people, you know, show up and I don't have a house for them. Oh? Super jerky? For 75 amber? There's no way in hell I can afford that, but let's take a look. They're basically telling me to scrap everything I own. But I can't even get enough amber out of him, so it's a moot point. Bathhouse or forum? We'll do that one. We're not gonna get either of them yet. Ooh. Oh. Was hoping for that. Cannot afford it. I don't know, I don't really feel like continuing this right now. But I think we're off to a good start on this. As you can see, the Rainpunk system has been pretty well incorporated. Like, the geysers aren't the only way of getting it now, so even, like, this one rain collector can run this pure, like, crafting building. In fact, I could probably save on some humans here. I didn't even realize this, but they actually do till the ground underneath these buildings. That's funny. I don't know why I'm chopping out there when I can't even house people out there. There, obviously. I'm just setting this up for next time, because I don't plan on continuing just yet. That was like a good 90 minutes against the storm anyway. Besides, I just wanted to check out the new update and get that vote done. Sorry for people watching the VOD that wasn't a complete. I just got bored. What else can we do? Dingo, you still around? I do have to be at the D&D session in about 4 hours. It's not D&D, it's Pathfinder. Where's the button to become large again? Well, all of my friends are live right now. These are not my usual hours, so I gotta go support them instead, I think. But later, we will be at the Pathfinder 2E with Mina as the Dungeon Master on Midnight Queen Lillian's channel. Vespa, check GC. Oh no. Don't tell me it got canceled. Hang on. That's unfortunate. Allie's not going to be able to... Yeah, but... Allie's going to be working from now on, so we need to decide what we're doing. We might play without her today and then reschedule. I don't know what Mina wants to do. But I've been waiting for this for like 2-3 months, so I'd prefer if we managed to actually play. If possible. Although I will miss Allie. Same? Just say something about that in the group chat then. You don't get to be aggressively lesbian with Allie. That just means that you get to introduce your character before she becomes a horny lesbian. That means that it's not going to be your only defining character trait. I know that that's scary, but you can do it. Char is still doing Beat Saber. I think we're going to raid her. It's a very short stream today. I promise tomorrow's will be longer. And we will be live, just not on this channel, later today. So, thank you everybody for coming. I will raid Virtual Char, and we will go watch her get really sweaty, and hopefully take her clothes off. I mean, what? You got a meme you should post in the... Yeah, I mean... Don't make Allie feel bad about her scheduling, Lob. That's all I'll say. I know that memes about getting the D&D canceled are funny, but not to new players. Especially when they're the ones whose fault it is. In their minds. Anyway, let me do that raid. Thank you for letting me know, Lob. That's not the meme? Oh, okay. Fair enough. That's usually the memes that I see. It's a meme about being aggressive. Okay. Fair enough. I feel like my character should be wearing glasses right now because I'm having trouble seeing without them. But that wouldn't help me see. That would help nothing. Just a weird delusion for a half second there. I don't know. I've installed some other stuff. I've installed Elden Ring. I've installed Halo. I've installed a couple of games that I might want to check out next week. And we're getting the new outfit. Sometime soon. Be ready. Be happy. Maybe I'll take a chance to actually upload some of the fucking VODs to the archive channel. I'm still uploading in December. Oh. I'm still uploading shit that was streamed in December. If you're watching this, and this wasn't uploaded in February, hit me in the face, because it's like February 3rd. Hit me in the face platonically. Raid, Virtually Char, who is cute, and love, and love, and love. I'll be honest, I didn't want to play, because I know that my friends are all doing stuff. I really need to stick to my morning schedule. Anyway, bye-bye. Yamete, no, what's the word that, what does Yatra say? Bye-bye, Janae? I don't remember. Go. You too, person watching this in the future. Don't be cringe. Yeah, that's right. Don't be cringe. Yeah, anyway, bye.